The first one is Nortico Alvarinho. And so this
is,
that's okay. It sounded good, you know. This is Portuguese. So you've heard of Alvarinho from Spain. Basically in Portugal, they just switch out the B for a V. It's Alvarinho.
I'll let you pretend like I'm cultured.
You know all about Alvarinho from Spain,
yeah,
of course. It's a great crisp white from the Atlantic coast. This is up in the Vinho Verde area of Portugal.
And Vinho Verde, I know what that means, green grapes.
Green grapes, yes, okay. but really like this zesty and citrusy and sort of lively for summer and really good. And I like it as an alternative to Sauvignon Blanc because it doesn't have the kind of grassiness and the green pepperiness of Sauvignon Blanc, but it's got all that
citrus. That's interesting. I like Sauvignon Blanc, but it doesn't have the grassiness?
Well,
and the,
sometimes when you smell a Sauvignon Blanc, particularly New Zealand, you get that kind of green pepper note. Cut grass. Well, people either like it a lot or they hate it a lot.
Hmm. So, but I like this too.
But so, you just like everything.
I'm a lush, right?
So,
moving on.
Next, so this is a wine that I wrote up for our June issue. This is a Matthew Fritz Pinot Noir from North Coast of California.
Okay.
$15 a bottle, and it's really hard to find good Pinot for under $25.
$15.
$15 a bottle, I tasted this. I was tasting a bunch of cheap Pinots.
Wow.
Most of them were horrible.
And I don't really like red wines.
This is good. I was blown away by this. It's got that beautiful berry fruit that Pinot has.
Yeah.
It's got like it's light bodied. It's great. You could chill it down a little for summer, and it's just a steal. It's $15.
I can't believe it's a great bottle of wine. I like that. You always bring me some great options. I don't even like red, but I like.
And there we go. And this
cans.
Is so canned wine. So I was on here. I was on this show a year ago saying. by the way, I should have mentioned sparkling canned wine in this case.
Yeah,
sorry about that. But I was on here a year ago saying that canned wines were this up-and-coming trend. You can drink from the can. You can drink from the glass.
I'm gonna drink from the glass.
This is called Nomakai. It's a sparkling Pinot Noir, sparkling rosé, and I think it's delicious. Kind of got this tangerine-y fruit and little bubbles and kind of crisp and. You know,
and it comes in a can.
Comes in little tiny cans, kind of a single serving. You take it to the beach, take it on a hike. You know,
now
you can open it next to your face and spray yourself with wine. Do whatever you like, really.
But how big are cans at this point?
Cans are still a tiny percentage of the market, but the growth rate is like this. So you're going to see more and more and more of them, no question.
What's the next one?
Okay, next one. Back to Portugal. I love this wine. This wine is suggested retails $10 a bottle. I can find it for
$10.
Yeah,
$8.
$8 and.
It was like $2.
People forget about Portuguese wine. It's like the European country that's a major wine country that people never think about. And
that's pretty good.
This is Alforjeiro Trincadeira. I mean, weird Portuguese varieties.
It's light though, I don't particularly
fruity,
care for red wines, but this is a light enough
fruity,
one that I would
juicy,
drink it.
Take it out to the picnic, have it with a burger. Super
I can see
simple.
That. Yeah.
And then my splurge.
I can't.
And I know you're looking forward
this.
To this. Tequila, because you have to have good tequila for the summer.
This is not a reflection of this tequila brand. I am not a tequila drinker.
Yeah.
Sell me on this. Try it.
So, Volcan de Mitiara, new brand. This is called the Cristalino Tequila. It's basically an oak-aged tequila that's been filtered to take out the woody notes. So you get that beautiful agave kind of
vegetable
character.
It doesn't smell as paint thinnery as I would expect.
See, it's very good. It's $65 a bottle, but it's very good. And it smells
if I can bring myself to
do it. You know, it's got that beautiful kind of agave note, and it's still got a little of the creaminess. Take a small sip.
Let me see.
It's incredibly smooth. It's not what you think of tequila as like burning and harsh.
Yeah, it's not nearly as awful as I thought it was
going to
be.
You're going back to the Pinot Noir, aren't you?
No, actually, that's very, very light. So, why is that? Why doesn't it taste like the nastiness?
Because it's 100% blue agave. It's made, with artisanal methods. It's a very craft production tequila that's then been been aged in oak but then filtered back so it loses the color but it keeps that smoothness that you get from oak aging.
I will give you smooth. I will give you that.
So it's a beautiful sipping tequila. Or you could have a $15 Pinot Noir if you prefer Pinot Noir to tequila, for instance.
Yes.